Today I'm going to show you a really simple way to set the mood of a picture. Hello my friends, and let's get started. So I prepared two pictures. One is this and the other one is this picture, and we want to have another light mood on the picture. And to do this, you can use any kind of picture you find online, for example this one or this one, where you like the light and the mood of the picture and apply this to the other photo. The only thing we have to do, first of all, you have to rasterize this. So over here it says pixel on the side of the layer. And then what we're going to do is just click the layer, go to filters, blur and average. And we're going to do this with the other picture too, that we use as a light source or a mood source. So click it, blur and average. So this is now an average color. And now what we're going to do is we will just set this layer to either overlay or soft light. And you can see instantly that this is going to change the way that the light feels and that the picture feels. So you can get a really nice situation. Let's do this with the other picture too. Let's set it to soft light. And there you go. You have kind of an evening light, which is very nice. It's also soft. It's an interesting kind of light. You can also set it to overlay. Overlay is often more intense, so soft light is probably in most cases the better choice. Let's see with the other picture. You can see even here the colors look interesting and nice. But one thing you can realize, or what you can see, is that it applies to all of the picture in the same way. And this might not be ideal. For example, I would suggest to you that you apply it more to the light and colorful areas and less to the dark and black and white areas here. So what you can do to achieve that is select the layer that you're using as your color source and click over here on the little wrench. And then you have this, and where it says underlying composition ranges, you just pull down the left side as far as you want to go, and then maybe make a second point here and move it along to see what happens to the colors in the picture. And this means if this is lower here, it doesn't apply to the darker parts of the picture. And you can see when I move it up, the darker parts become more colorful, and when I move it down, they adapt less of the color of what we overlaid. So you can see that this now applies more to just these parts, the lighter parts, and less to these parts. We can look at this in the other picture too, of course. Here you can also see, let's go to the wrench again, move this up and move it down. And you can see it especially in the area of the hair and the area of the shadows around the eyes. When I put this up, this light is also in the hair that makes it look a little bit flat and a little bit too bright maybe, or it has too less contrast. But if I pull this down, you see that I get less of the color in the darker areas, and so I restore the contrast and the picture starts to look interesting again. But still, I have the light effect, which makes the picture look nice and soft. We can do this with the other layer too. I have hidden the first layer. We have the other layer now with the blue light. And again, we can pull this down and make a second point here to adjust our curve where we want to have it. And you can see that this really has a great effect on where the light is going, where the light is having an effect on. So this is a very good way to do that. Another thing that you can do, I will go back to the first picture. So we overlaid the light like this, and you could use it in a way that you have less of this influence on the top of the picture. And the way to do that is to go to the layer with your color and make a mask, pull it onto the layer, and then use the brush, set it to a low opacity like here, 26% opacity, 7% hardness, so it's very soft. Set it to a good size and color black. And then you can just brush over this and reduce the visibility of the color in these areas. You can see I brush a little bit over these areas, and so I have less of the effect here than I had before. It's very subtle. I'm not sure you can see it on YouTube, but it is there. It's reducing the effect. It's still there, but it's less of the effect, which makes sense because towards the sky, because there is the light source, things are brighter and less colorful, and on the lower parts there is less light and things have a little bit more contrast and more color, so it makes sense. It looks a little bit more natural to do it like this, and it's an additional way to influence this. And like I said, you can use any picture, any light mood that you like. Don't maybe use too extreme light moods because it looks unnatural, unless this is what you're looking for. So just feel free to experiment with this. It's a very quick and easy thing to do and to correct the picture. As you can see, the original picture looks kind of, it looks good but not nice from the mood, and with this applied, the mood is very nice and very soft and warm. Okay, thank you very much for watching. It was a short tutorial today. If you like my videos, maybe subscribe. I do 2 videos per week. And if you want to support me even more, head over to Patreon, where you can download my files with all the layers, get feedback on your own work, and suggest topics to me that you want to see in future tutorials. Thank you very much, and see you next time. Bye.